Hey, happy Sunday, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman Plus. Now, I'm going to give you the latest update on what's going on with this Gulf storm, this potential tropical storm, potentially low-grade hurricane that could form in the Gulf of Mexico from this Invest. This is Invest 91L. It is moving northwest at 3 miles per hour. It's already at max winds of 29 miles per hour. It just needs to get a closed center of circulation before it could be officially tropical depression, tropical storm that's going to be forming up. Now, this is going to be Francine, this one over here that's in the western MDR, the main development region. This is Invest 92L. It is moving northwest also at 3 miles per hour, also 29 miles per hour sustained wind so far. Now, this one over here, I'm showing maybe by the Leeward Islands, maybe by Puerto Rico, maybe even by the British and Virgin Islands. Needs to be on a little bit of your eyes open. What's up with this? The trend has been that this is going to turn at the last minute and just go right into the Atlantic. Potentially just being a fish storm, we do need to watch out for Bermuda as well, because this is strengthening. Matter of fact, this has a good chance to be major Hurricane Gordon out here in the Atlantic. I'm not showing any main threats other than potentially Puerto Rico for the United States from that tropical wave. We have another threat that's coming after that tropical wave and in the beginning of October. So I'm going to show you all the latest information in this video. If you've never been here before, make sure you subscribe. I am all year long. I will keep you updated on anything that happens in the tropics. Make sure you click that bell and select all so you do get the updates. Now you can see the update just like my last video. These two are merging together, still going to the south. This one's going to pull up north and they're going to meet right along that front boundary and start getting convection and start forming up. Still showing this is not going anywhere to the east. So anywhere from Mississippi and over, you get some rainfall, but you're not going to see any strong winds as this tries to become a very low-grade hurricane. It's pretty much going to be the same impacts, whether it's a low-grade hurricane or a high-end tropical storm anyway. Not seeing any more strength past that. Now, so far, they have it 80% in the next 48 hours, 90% in the next 7 days, and it's definitely forming within probably the next 48 hours for sure, maybe even the next 24 hours. Now, watches could be put out later on this afternoon for portions of the western Gulf Coast later today or tonight. And aircraft reconnaissance is going into this storm, so we'll have more information for you on the update this afternoon. And Invest 92L, it is going to become a tropical depression. It's still showing it will be that Gordon, potentially major hurricane, but showing it's going to drift westward going 10 miles per hour, very slow, and then it's going to curve out to the north. There is no high pressure doing any kind of blocking or anything crazy in the Atlantic. No signs of that. Now, of course, I will keep my eye on it. I'm not showing any problems as far as this wave. Still the Eastern Caribbean. Keep your eyes open just a little bit, potentially for some winds that might come with this. Remember, this will be east side loaded, so it won't be no impacts on y'all. And disturbance three way out here. Just don't even worry about this. This is going to curve very strongly towards the Atlantic. And we still have that other one coming in later in September. Now, this is the one that's going to be strengthening and potentially going right through the Caribbean. Now, you can see as of this morning, we have a lot of warm temperatures still in the Caribbean, still in the Gulf of Mexico. But right along the Gulf Coast by Texas, this is where you're a little bit below average all the way towards Louisiana. Now, we still have a system that's pushing through a little cold front. This is going to put some dry air and some shear on this system, and it's going to make it very hard for the western side of the cyclone to form up and strengthen up. It's going to be fighting this all the way towards landfall. And you can see from the Euro chance for a tropical depression is 100% as it goes towards Texas and then starts curving on that northeastward turn. And you can see that other wave as it meanders into the Atlantic, not really showing a big threat. I will keep my eye on that. Now, I wasn't going to show this if it wasn't going to be accurate. This is the artificial intelligence of the Euro accurately been showing this is going to be a tropical storm strengthening down, trying to become a hurricane at the last minute, but a tropical storm still showing on landfall as it goes towards Louisiana. Now, remember, when it goes on landfall, if this was the location, you would be getting winds on this side as well as the banding whipping around will bring you chances for tornadoes. Now, usually these tropical tornadoes are quick spin-ups and nothing really to worry about, but you see it also stays a little bit stronger according to this one as it goes on land, further onshore, bringing chances potentially for more impacts for rain and wind, but all the way up towards the Tennessee and Kentucky Valley. Now you can also see when you look at your relative humidity up in the atmosphere, you can see that it starts strengthening, but your precipitation starts getting moved to the east off of the center. And when you see that, you're seeing signs of sheer and then dry air getting in there. See all the precipitation moving east? So it's going to stop it, even though it's going somewhat on a strengthening phase, very slowly. It's going to stop it from doing rapid intensification because you won't have thunderstorms all around the center, all the way towards landfall. So that will prohibit it from doing rapid intensification. It can still strengthen up a little bit, but nothing super crazy. That's why we're still showing a tropical storm, maybe even a low-grade hurricane that could weaken right back down right towards landfall because of the dry air getting in on that system and creating a lot of weakness. Matter of fact, you can see how weak this could potentially be because of the dry air and the shear prohibiting the storm from forming very strong in the center. This is the control member of the Ural Ensembles. And the update, the latest update, 6Z, only goes towards 6 days, showing a very weak system. And once again, this will bring some rain and some banding coming along this side, so be warned of that, but not showing anything great coming out of that system. And I'm going to show you a trend. So when we go by deterministic of the model, you can see almost the same trend. It starts going towards the coast of Texas. Now we go to a previous run, it showed it a little bit stronger right at that point, and we're already seeing a weakness on an update. So even though the previous run shows it could go a little bit further, still showing something very weak, you see how you get that curve happening with it. Now the longer it stays offshore and curves around, gives it a potential chance for it to be a stronger tropical storm. But like I said, on the latest run, you can see how that shows a lot more weakness than the previous run. Now, when we go by GFS, we all know GFS is designed to be on the highest peak. Ural is on the lowest peak. That way you can see what the difference is. GFS takes it right towards a hurricane, and then it starts going towards landfall in the same area that you're seeing on artificial intelligence of the Ural. But the artificial intelligence of the Ural is not seeing a hurricane the whole time. It's seeing a strong tropical storm potentially go to a very low-grade hurricane and then go right back down to a tropical storm. So let's go through the trends a little bit more. I'm almost done. When we look at a hurricane models, we can look at this when we have the invest. And you see just at your 10-meter winds, it does start to strengthen up. But its best chance gets all the way down to 67 miles per hour winds right before landfall. Don't even make it towards a hurricane at all. Now, when we go and look at hurricane analysis forecast system A, it takes it all the way down potentially to 81 miles per hour winds. It shows it tries to go down to a hurricane, weakens down after that because of the dry air and the shear, and tries again to go down towards a hurricane. So either way, you're looking at a strong tropical storm to a low-grade hurricane, only a Cat 1. This will bring some winds. It will bring some flooding as well. It will bring some waves, and it will bring a lot of rain with it. But what it's not bringing is a Cat 2, a Cat 3, any of that. So just be aware you have a strong tropical storm, potentially a low-grade hurricane passing by as we go from Tuesday into Wednesday, and it could last all the way to Wednesday evening into Thursday before it finally does landfall. Still showing that we have that strengthening phase of this system from the 10th through the 12th from GFS, and still seeing the very same thing on the Euro as well. And you can see here from the Euro that it shows chances for it to start strengthening up as it goes off the coast of Texas and goes on that angle towards southeastern Texas and western Louisiana, bringing convection, bringing chance for some storms to form as it strengthens along this path. And then you can see how Gordon becomes that major hurricane that's going right out into the Atlantic. So when you look at the chance for the tracks and guidance, you look at automatic tropical cyclone forecast showing literally in 72 hours, that's when it's going to start being on that strengthening phase a little bit and start going on that curve. Now you can see the same thing on the Canadian model as well, showing right where artificial intelligence Euro has been showing. And you can see it on a European as well, seeing that curve at the last minute and potentially do a little bit of strengthening at the last minute, but you don't see it on all of them. Remember that. And you can see with GFS showing the exact same thing as well. Latest update shows that it will be a tropical storm and more likely will stay towards a strong tropical storm before it goes to landfall right around 4 days. Now, there is a few members that's showing it could be on that low-end Cat 1 hurricane. But once again, a low-end Cat 1, a strong tropical storm, there's not much difference in the winds. It's still going to be a big rain and flooding event. Now, I'm still showing after we deal with this one, which is going to be Francine, that we still have another one coming in the late 20s. This is not Invest 92L. This is a total different wave. And then we have another wave coming after that, still at the beginning of October. Seeing a little bit more weakness, but it's still there. Remember, we did follow this all the way from the beginning of the phase. Now it's moving up a little bit because that one's a little bit more worrisome. That's the one that's showing a little bit more of a westward push. And that's the one that's showing that we have all this favorable environment, all this lift propagating across our area as we go from the high teens into the 20s. So that wave does have a good chance to grow. It don't have all the sinking air like we've been having for the whole hurricane season almost. And still showing by the Euro control member that it has a chance to strengthen up and come around the Caribbean and the coast of the lower 48. Still showing regardless of the strength of this storm. Remember, once again, that's only going to bring a little bit more winds. You still got all this tropical moisture that's going to pull up. And like I showed you with the Euro last time, showing it's going to go all the way into Arkansas, still showing true. So as we look at the Euro artificial intelligence, which was accurate with this model as well as what this wave was doing, you can see it's getting very little bit of rainfall from southern Texas along the coast of Texas, get a little bit heavier as you go towards southeastern Texas. Showing a lot of the heaviness is going to be from Louisiana moving north and east. So far it's showing a big heavy spot of 6 to 7 inches for Louisiana going into Mississippi, and 3 to 4 inches going all the way up towards eastern Arkansas, some of Missouri, southern Illinois, and western Tennessee and Kentucky, and across the deep south. Look at that, Mississippi, Alabama, stretching across Florida and the Carolinas as well. Showing so far, as we start for tomorrow, you do have chances for marginal all the way from Florida across the Gulf Coast. Start getting a little bit of a slight risk for southern Texas for that heavy rainfall that's going to start coming with this tropical moisture. As we go into Tuesday, this is where it's going to grow. It's going to grow for the whole Gulf Coast for Texas, Louisiana, and Mississippi. You're still going to be in the marginal across Florida. But as you go into Wednesday, this is where it comes in for that impact for that landfall. And you're in the slight risk all the way up to the marginal for Arkansas for the flash flooding. Now, Thursday, as this goes onshore, this is where it does a little bit more of an impact all the way up towards eastern Arkansas, western Tennessee, all the way up towards western Kentucky with the marginal. But this is where your flash flooding grows as you go from Tuesday into Wednesday into Thursday, just the impacts from the system. Now, so far, GFS is showing the most strength, which is not a surprise. So if it was true to be a low-grade hurricane on impact, you can see most of the impacts will be across Louisiana, bringing anywhere from the 50 miles per hour wind gusts, this is wind gusts, all the way up potentially towards the 60s as you go towards the West Bank. And you see it does carry into the 40s and the 50s, all the way up into Mississippi, all the way up to western Tennessee as well. So we just got to see which one is correct. This here is actually your worst case scenario. Now, I will keep my eye on the rest of the tropics so everyone knows exactly what is going on as we go through these transitions, especially of this month. Thank you again for your time, everybody. Hope you have a great Sunday out there. I will do an afternoon update because things always change. I just don't see a lot of change going on, but I appreciate every single one of you. Now, before you go today, Psalm 90, 1-4. Lord, thou hast been our dwelling place in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth, or ever thou hast formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. Thou turnest man to destruction and sayest, return, ye children of men, for 1,000 years in thy sight are but as yesterday when it is past, and as a watch in the night. Amen. I hope you all have a very great day today, and remember, above all things, all glory goes to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. I'll see you this afternoon.